So, welcome to the first episode of Otori Monogatari. So, that is a new arc in the Monogatari second season. And yeah, we were watching this before going into Hana Monogatari because that was the vote results. As I said, I don't have too much of an involvement in that vote, so I'm not gonna talk too much about it. I feel like that was the only kind of fair way to decide it. I know some people are gonna be disappointed that we're not watching Hana Monogatari in between, but I feel like it's not gonna be that big of a deal. We're gonna be watching Hana Monogatari as soon as we finish the entire Monogatari second season. It also makes it a bit easier to title on YouTube, you know? It's a bit more continuous, you know? But yeah, either way, it is now time to go into Otori Monogatari, which I believe is a Nadeko arc. I think they called it Nadeko Medusa arc at the end of the last episode, so I'm excited for it because, as I said, it definitely felt like the first Nadeko arc felt like it ended on a bit of a anticlimactic note, right? It didn't feel like anything was resolved. It just felt like we kind of brushed it aside and were like, yeah, you know what? It's probably fine. Let's go into the next arc. So now it's going to be fun seeing how that ends up. You know, I feel like Nadeko, out of all of the characters that we've seen so far that were like that had their own arcs, Nadeko was definitely the least involved one up until this point. In like all of the other arcs that weren't her arc. So I'm excited to see, you know, more of Nadeko because she is an interesting character and I wonder how we're gonna flesh out this, like her story and her arc, her, I don't know, insecurities, whatever it's gonna end up being, because her arc wasn't necessarily that directly, you know, it wasn't her direct struggles. It was a curse inflicted by others onto her, which I guess in turn would mean that she's dealing with bullying at school. But still, I guess we'll see how it ends up going. But yeah, in the previous arc, we just finished all of the time traveling shenanigans. You guys clarified a few details that I may have missed, so thank you for that. But yeah, it was a banger of an arc. And I think, honestly, my favorite arc so far is probably still Neko Monogatari Shiro. But the previous one was really good as well. So yeah, anyways, I am really excited to see where the Nadeko arc goes because I'm sure it's going to be crazy. It's going to be really good. So I'm excited for it. Anyways, if you want to watch this, Uncut and Unblurred, it's going to be on my Patreon, which is down in the description. And without further ado, let's go into Otori Monogatari Episode 1.
Oh.
Yes. Same.
Okay. Oh!
38! Damn. That's a lot. Wow. Wow. That's interesting. That was very ominous, by the way. A gaslighting snake? Interesting. Whoa! What a pessimistic way to look at the world, this snake.
Ah. した。こっちを見ろよ、戦国。
That's our Araji。
殺しに来たぜ、戦国。
暦お兄ちゃんは吸血鬼だと言います。しかしその吸血鬼ゆえの回復力というのは、こうして見る限り全くと言っていいほど発揮されていない。
ああ、ファーン、クール
。貫いたままなのさ。
そっか、そうだっけ。だよね、そうなんだよね。なでこだった、なでこが悪いんだった。言い訳の余地なく、上々酌量の余地なく、
okay.
なでこが悪いんだった。じゃあちゃんと戦わないと。
身も心もすっかり怪異に出してしもうたという感じじゃの。
She has become an oddity? What the fuck? Okay, rewind to the beginning of this. Yes, thank you. Rewind. I was waiting for the rewind. I knew they were gonna do a rewind, so I was just waiting for it. Okay, come on, Kana Hanazawa. Drop it. I never heard this song before, so let's see it.Decoy, Otori. Okay. Oh!Oh, this goes hard. Oh, doki doki indeed, man. Okay.So, first of all, the song goes so hard. Like, I love the record scratches in it. It's so good. But also, Kana Hanazawa's voice. Oh my god. So cool. But, okay, so the opening scene, it seems like it's very anxiety-inducing. Like, it feels like it's Nadeko definitely is feeling very anxious. It feels like she's very much feeling the... I don't know if it's jealousy. I think it's some kind of anxiety.It's also feeling like maybe she's not good enough. She's not where she wants to be. I think it's more so that's what it feels like. It feels like, oh, what? It doesn't feel necessarily as, oh, I am jealous of Shinobu for being there. It more so feels like, why am I not good enough to be there? But that's purely off of this short clip that we've seen there. So maybe it's not as simple as that. I'm gonna guess that it's more feelings than that. Usually, that would be attributed to, you know, puberty and stuff like that. So I wonder which direction this is gonna go in. So I guess we'll see. Oh my god. What an opener. Okay, yeah. Sounds good. She sounds very nervous. Interesting. 31st of October. What? 2006? Ogi? Whoa! Uchi no Ogi! Ah! Oh! We skipped the entire September, October, and the end of August? Oh, she's... Ah, I faux pas, man. Sorry about that. What the... Nadeko doesn't know Hachikuji. Why does... Ogi know? First year. Yeah, okay. Are you? What? I'm gonna go back. I'm gonna go back to something that she said. The stuff with Sengoku-chan is basically a side story. Things probably won't end up like they did with Hanekawa Tsubasa. I don't know if that's a joke. So
おじさんはそういう考え方は嫌いだったと思うけれど、ま、得て てして世の中には被害者しかいないということなのかもしれない。ということはさらに裏返して、戦国ちゃんも最初からあんまり純然たる被害者というわけでもないのかな。そして今回の物語ではそれがあらわになるのかもね。
物語？
ああ、まさかそれとも戦国ちゃん、君は自分がまるっきり物語性のない日常の中を生きているなんて思っているわけでもないだろう。じゃ
あ、
あれ、なぜか不思議なことにそんなに話し込んでいたつもりはないのに、気がつけば結構時間が過ぎてしまっていたのです。
Wait, what? 11 minutes?
まるで時間を盗まれたかのように。さておき、学校に到着し、
Okay. Oh, my brain. Okay, so first of all, the big thing here is Oshino Meme, he supposedly, according toToOgi, if she is to be trusted when it comes to her saying that she's Meme's niece, that means that Meme has a sibling. Okay, we don't know. Yeah, we don't know any siblings of Meme's. Okay, interesting. And then another thing is, I mean, there's a thin line. She was definitely, I mean, she was throwing shade at Sengoku, right? She was basically victim blaming. Now, there's a fine line between victim blaming and actually like genuinely criticizing someone for playing the victim, right? If someone's playing the victim too hard, I mean obviously that's fair, you can criticize that, right? If you have solid grounds for doing so, but even then I feel like you have to be careful, because obviously I'm sure they usually have some kind of reason for it. It's a fine line. But I feel like she definitely dug into Nanako a lot here. But yeah, I wonder how much of it is actually fair and how much of it is just pure victim blaming and gaslighting, because it seems very similar to how the snake was talking to her. It seems very gaslighty, being like, yeah, you're just playing up the victim persona and stuff like that. So I wonder. Interesting. Let's see.
That
made me late. Is the snake supposed to be some kind of trauma? Melancholic.
しいてそんな事態を招いた原因となる人物を無記名の投票で一人選ぶとするなら、満場一致であの詐欺師さん、怪奇伝習さんということになるのだと思います。
Yeah, text out.
あ、いえ、
Queen.
知り合いみたいに言っていますけれど、なでこはその人に会ったことはありません。ただ、知り合い以上です。関わり方としては超重要人物、VIP と言っていいでしょう。
Because he sold the curses or thing is the, yeah.
Ah.
There's no way, like, hearing everything here, that you can blame her and saying that she's playing the victim. She definitely, in part, was a victim, right? I feel like one of the worst things you could do is look at someone who's actually had, like, a really, really traumatic and rough experience and call them, say that they're playing the victim. I feel like that's so mentally horrible and destroying for that other person, right? Especially if they've been going through such a hard time. Like, okay, I'm sure they're gonna be more nuanced to this, but still, I feel like it's horrible looking at someone, not knowing many details about it, or even knowing many details and saying that they're playing the victim, even though they've been going through such a horrible, horrible situation. Also, it seems really interesting how, what's her name? Ogi asked Nadeko, oh, are you not living a life that's like worth telling a story about? And then now we're seeing here that her life is very melancholic, very boring, if you will, and very not story-esque, I guess. It could be just the toxic environment and like atmosphere around it. Around the class. And like how on edge everyone is. Yeah, she sucks the energy out of them. Yes. She delays them.
は全くないのですから。
おい、
いおい、そりゃねえだろ、なでこちゃん。あ身に覚えがないだって。
Is that the snake?Bro, can you stop victim blaming her ass? I see. So basically we're saying it's not necessarily other people that are victim blaming her as much. It's more so her blaming herself for everything that happened and basically saying that she shouldn't be the victim here because she's at fault, right? I feel like that's a very, not normal, but very often, often you see that in people who are feeling like who are very depressed and stuff like that, they usually think, oh, I did something wrong. Oh, it was my fault that this is happening. Even if they are actually a victim, you see that a lot, especially if it's like something like a toxic relationship or something, right? And I feel like that's what's happening with Nadeko. I feel like the snake is more so a representation of herself. At least that's my early interpretation of this. It feels like the snake is more so of herself saying to herself, oh, you're at fault. You shouldn't be playing the victim here because you're the one who caused it, right? I think? Medusa. Medusa.Guilt tripping her as well?What a professional, oh no, manipulator. It's no balls.
近づいています。
ふん、
100% の食塩水300リットルに 10% の食塩水300リットルを混ぜ合わせた600リットルの食塩水に 20% の食塩水400リットルを加えたものを半分飲むと何パーセントの食塩水何リットルになるでしょう。
What?Yeah, it's, you can't have 100%.
次回、おとり物語第2話、なでこメデューサその2。ではでは、50% の食塩水100リットルを、そんなに溶けねえよ。
Okay. Oh my god, what a start to the arc, man. Okay, so that's really interesting. Definitely, the energy of this arc just feels like so, not heavy, maybe, but anxiety-inducing. So you feel the anxiety that she's feeling. You feel the, I guess it is a bit heavy as well, the melancholy, the, oh, I mean, it just feels like beating someone down where they're at their lowest, man. It doesn't feel good at all, man. It just, now, I don't know, the snake could very well just be like an actual thing, not necessarily completely mental, kind of more similar to the crab, right?Where a snake is just someone who's actually taking advantage of someone who's at their lowest. It seems that way. And dude, what a master manipulator, man. Guilt tripping her, victim blaming her, gaslighting her, everything. Using every trick in the book. Oh man, poor Nadeko. Jesus Christ. Yeah, as I said, I mean, I feel like Ogi in that scene, I'm gonna take a guess and say thatThe reason that she said the things that she said is because she actually wanted to help Nadeko. She wanted to give her some motivation to be like, yo, stop thinking that way. You gotta pick yourself up. But I have a feeling that's a big gamble just because, I mean, if you say someone stop pretending to be a victim, right? If you victim blame someone like this, I feel like that's very, very, very hard to do.Correctly, because especially if someone is just at their lowest, it's not gonna be nice for them, right? So yeah, I feel like Ogi had good intentions there, and she definitely knows a lot more than she lets on. But so maybe this entire situation, like, she knows exactly how it's gonna go down, maybe, but it doesn't feel like Nadeko's feeling the greatest about it. I feel like it was definitely very on the nose. So I hope that Nadeko, I mean, we sawWhat it's gonna eventually lead to, so... God. Okay, really interesting though. Really, really interesting. Yeah, as I said, I feel like the snake is either... I feel like it's just an accumulation of all of the above said things, like all of her insecurities, all of her anxieties, all of her just feelings that she's feeling right now in the class, all of the blame that she's feeling as well. Yeah. Anyways, very interesting, very, very cool first episode to the arc. I'm so excited to see where this arc goes. Also, I'm really surprised that we jumped to October 31st. We jumped from August 21st to October 31st. So we jumped over 2 months in the future. That's crazy. That's genuinely crazy. I wonder if, let's say, Hanamonogatari was maybe in the middle, in those, like, in September or something, maybe. Or maybe nothing happened in those months. I don't know. I guess we'll see in the future arcs. Obviously, don't spoil anything because we're going to be watching all of it. Yeah, we're gonna see in the future, I'm sure. But yeah, anyways, banger of the first episode. And I'm gonna end this one here. Hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, make sure to like, comment, subscribe. And I'll see you in the next one. Peace.